Hi, here we are at the 15th annual Jamaica Stock Exchange conference at the Pegasus Hotel. And we've been hearing all of, for a long time now, about artificial intelligence, AI. Sir, my name is Michael Sharp. What is yours?
My name is Kimar Knight.
K-N-I-G-H-T.
Yes, K-N-I-G-H-T.
Mr. Knight, take us from Knight today. Yes, artificial intelligence. You know what that is?
Well, artificial intelligence is just some robot inside the cloud that can assist you in your everyday life. In businesses, we can program them to help with the business processes. NCB has been using artificial intelligence for some years now. Yes, so we have Liz right here, which can also assist with the floor management. Let's say for the bank, we can use it to onboard customers using facial ID, but due to the process that the artificial intelligence cannot verify paperwork, they would still have to interact with human beings. Because for me, I think, and I spend an average of about 30 to an hour inside of a bank just to maybe do some personal business transaction. But with an artificial intelligence, we can now speed up that process.
You have slipped a couple things by us and we didn't notice. First of all, the name of this machine is Liz.
Liz.
That's a female name.
Yeah.
And I suspect she, what do you call it, it or she?
Well, it's actually a it, but based on the fact that it has a female voice, we just refer to it as a Liz, as for short.
What can it do? What can this machine do? And why should I bring it in my business? And what is it? Describe, first of all, what is this machine?
All right, so this machine here is a shell. It was brought in from China and programmed here locally in Jamaica. So it's based on the business module that you're looking for, or the process that you're looking for. So in a realtor store, you will be able to identify where items are and also give a description if the item is in stock, or take you to the item. Take you to the item.
You mean she moves?
Yeah, she moves. So right now, I will give you a tour. Not a tour. I will take you down to the Jamaica Observer. So
describe what you're doing as you do it.
All right. So on screen, we can select the map. She will display a map of the lobby we're in now. So if I was supposed to say, take me to the Observer, we can use voice to do it, and we can also use manual.
Please follow me.
Okay. She turns and turns and turns.
So she's now looking for the best possible route to go down to the Jamaica Observer.
Okay.
So based on the fact that if somebody is standing in front of her or object is blocking her, she will not slam inside of the object. Yes, so now the Jamaica Observer is just a bit ahead. So after she reached there, she will just give you a bit of information about the Jamaica Observer.
But this has to be,
programmed. Yes, this has to be programmed inside of the robot.
So this is the Jamaica Observer here.
Yes.
So this lady has been...
paper published in Kingston, Jamaica. The paper is owned by Butch Stewart, who chartered the paper in January 1993 as a competitor to Jamaica's oldest daily paper, the Gleaner.
Well, it's kind and fair. This just didn't give us a loan. The Observer told us about the Gleaner too. So it's all balanced. She's not she's not preferring anyone. Hi, have you ever met Liz?
Yes, sir. I did.
And what's your name?
Andrea Beckford.
Andrea, hi Andrea, this is Liz, you see, she can do all kind of wonderful things. Can point you to where the newspapers are, can what else can she do?
All right, so I will now demonstrate the facial ID.
Yes. Facial ID.
Do you know me?
Okay, please stand in front of me.
So now she's scanning my face. Now she's scanning my face. Because she identified me, she extended her arms for a shake, right? So she can also dance.
Really?
Yes. So, all right, let me just do this. Can you dance?
I'm going to start dancing. Keep a distance of 1 meter with me.
Oh, she's going to do the cha-cha?
It's just for a little entertainment now and then. She may be standing in the lobby for some time when she's idle. You can set her to do a little entertainment to welcome the guests.
So we can go and dance with her and...
Yeah, if you want to cha-cha, you can do your cha-cha.
How long does she dance for?
Well, it's for a short period. It's not like it's going to take 2 minutes or so. Shortly, she will stop, and she will give you a message, maybe saying, don't make fun of her if you think she's a terrible dancer.
Who's going to drop her? I mean, she just has strong upper body strength, though.
Yes.
She doesn't move the legs.
Make fun of me if you think I'm a terrible dancer.
Okay, Liz, calm down. You know, you won't be dancing with the stars ever.
All right.
What else, you know, does she do?
All right, so at the moment, you can ask her questions, like simple questions, FAQ questions if onboarded. So for the question like this, tell me about Jamaica.
Jamaica is a lovely tropical island that is located in the Caribbean Sea. Millions of tourists visit Jamaica each year. They love Jamaica's lush topography of mountains, rainforests, and reef-lined beaches. Jamaica is famous for its rich culture, its reggae and dancehall music, its accomplished sportsmen and women, and its generally very talented people. Me love it here in Jamdown, and I especially love to rock to the reggae beat.
Pretty soon I'm going to hear say, Wagwan, Jamaica.
Yes, Wagwan, Jamaica.
We can, I noticed words came, script
yes.
Came out.
Yes, so if you don't want to listen to her, maybe you can just read ahead of her.
Oh, you guys are dumping on this girl already. Yes. Who wouldn't want to listen to Liz? How does it fit in the business world, though? I mean, you know, is it a lot to do with the programming, pre-programming? I mean, how does it fit?
All right, so it's just based off the business model, what the customer is actually looking for. So as I was referring to earlier, if it's the banking sector, we can just find a process that you would like her to take over. For instance, a lost credit card transaction. Like you lost your card and you want it to be replaced. Instead of going and sitting down in a long line, you could just go to her and start your process right there. Within a 5 minute time, the process could be finished.
Oh, you'd have a facial recognition.
And all of that to verify, maybe you use the RSA token, like NCB has RSA token to verify that
the numbers are correct, you're the right person
and all of that. So you could just upload all of that procedure here. And
Liz, when people are talking, you gotta calm down, all right?
I know you. Can you see it again?
All right, Liz, we'll soon come to you, okay?
All right, so based on the procedure, credit card transaction, you could just basically transfer funds and all of that. So it's just based on what you want, and we'll program it for you to fit in your business place.
I'm thinking like an inventory control. For example, you're in a storehouse. And you want to know how much you have left. All right, young lady. And you want to know how your inventory going. She could go down the line and show you where they are.
Well, well, she doesn't have to go down the line. But while she's there traveling in the aisles, sorry, she's calling customer care, which I am signing right now.
Okay.
Yes, so
she can make phone calls.
Yeah, she can make phone calls.
This girl, I'm on.
Yes, so because I was signing to customer care, if you were supposed to call, I would respond. Yes. Yeah, you can do video conferences as well. Okay. Yeah, so going back to the inventory warehouse thingy. Yes, while she's traveling along the aisles, she could also check to see what inventories you have low, or you could tie her into your database to do the query on spot. So in case you come in and you want to know, Liz, do we have any computers in stock today? She could stay there, query it, and say, we are currently low, or we only have one and it's on sale, because it can also do advertisement for you. So it could travel along the store offering promotion to the customers to say that we have a 20% discount on such items, and are you interested? Scan this barcode here, or whatsoever process you want.
Here comes the embarrassing question now. Should I take away my work?
She's not going to take away your work. It's just here to help human improve the customer care and also reduce the mundane tasks that we are facing every day.
All right, so that's a business place. Is there a version like her that I can take home to help me, tell me when the sugar down, the flour down, the cornmeal down, the rice down?
Yes, there is actually a domestic version, which...
So this version you call what version?
This is actually the commercial version.
So commercial version, and there's a domestic version. What can the domestic version do?
All right, so the domestic version now is a bit more advanced than this one. Sad to say, this one cannot open door physically, but the domestic version can open the door physically using processes like algorithms and all of that. We'll analyze how the door handle, how to hold it, and turn it and open it. Or if you're thirsty, you could ask it to say, walk up, go get me a drink. And no. Yes, it will open the fridge and retrieve a drink for you and carry it back to you personally. It will carry it back to you personally, right? And it won't let go until it knows that you have a perfect, yes, on the item.
So no, you broke it, you bought it business.
Yeah, no, broke it, you bought it business. And if you update your calendar into it, your schedule, to say that you have a date later, it could analyze the day, the weather, to say, all right then, Michael, there's going to be rain later. Goes for your umbrella, carry it to you, and say, here you go. Have a nice day.
Let me do it. I don't want a gender bias. What if you're a girl and you want to hear a guy voice? It can get a man voice?
Yes, you can get a man voice.
Just want to be sure, you know, because some girls don't want no Liz there or anybody. Or you can name your own machine?
Yes, you can name your own machine.
Where is this taking off? Where in the world is this taking off?
All right, so... In China is the leading, in the Asian part of the world, it's the leading industry right now, followed by America. Yeah, so we're now trying to introduce it into the Caribbean. So we're actually the exclusive realtors of Liz right here.
And it's in?
Well, Innovate 10X.
Innovate 10X.
Yeah, at 12 Kensington Crescent, New Kingston.
10x, I don't know what 10x means, and 10 multiply by whatever.
Yes, 10 multiply 10 folds. So that's our motto. So anything we're doing, we try to do it 10 times better.
10 times better. All right. Here comes the tough part now, the part that you were hoping that I would not have asked. Price point. I have to come to price point.
All right, the price point. Well, based on some studies, basic programming, including the module and everything, is just 25,000, but you have more
proper dollars.
25,000 US.
Yes, yeah,
$25,000.
Yes, $25,000 US. But if you want some more severe programming, it can go up to at least $100,000 US.
Okay, so you can customize if you care. When you say 25, like, you know, the basics, you're talking about the shell, and is it maintained? Or is there a maintenance thing that goes with that?
It's like a one-time cost. That $25,000 is like a one-time cost. The only reoccurring cost would be just like the internet bill and all of that.
Oh, it's an internet-based thing. What is the pipe coming through you? I'm gonna big a bit, the minimum that you have to have.
So the minimum, right now we're on 50 megs.
15?
50.
50 megs.
50 megs right now. But the best recommended would be at least 100 megs because it helps our process faster.
So in other words, you have to get a special pipe from the provider. There's 100 megs on, not in most houses.
Not in most offices, but at our office, we have her on a dedicated Wi-Fi, so that's her thing.
Nobody plays with Liz stuff.
Nobody plays with Liz stuff. Yes.
What's the interest been like here at the conference and in general?
Well, the interest has been tremendous, to be exact. Everybody's interested. Everybody likes to engage. They like to even see her dance.
Oh,
yes.
So she keeps saying, don't laugh at me, I don't think I'm a dancer, but she sounds a whole lot more serious than just a mere dancer, yes?
Yes. She's more serious. If I was supposed to even touch her while she's dancing, please don't touch me while I'm dancing.
Ooh, okay, all right. Don't get close to Liz, right? Yeah. Liz needs her personal space. And speaking of that, I get the sense that she needs space. X amount of space to work in.
Yeah, so while she's navigating, she needs space to navigate. So she won't hit in anything or anyone. So once she's navigating, somebody comes by and stands, she stops.
I'm powered by my heart. What is she powered by?
Her batteries and the servers.
Okay. Batteries. So how often you have to change those? I mean, you know, you're somebody looking on now and saying, you know, I want to get this girl, but what are some of the things that I have to change? How long the batteries? What are the guarantees?
All right, so the battery.
Sell me this machine.
Sell you this machine. Okay, Liz is powered by battery. She's self-charged. So once she's running low, she will find her charging station wherever it's on the map automatically and go there, charge whenever.
Wireless?
Yes, wireless. You just go there, connect and charge. Whenever she's ready, you turn her back on, and then she's ready to work. She can do surveillance as well. So at night, you can set her to patrol.
She takes pictures?
She doesn't take picture.
Okay, that's critical, you know. I don't want to be in the office and knowing this girl taking picture of me. So that's fine, that's fine. How long would a battery last in a day? What's the kind of
usage
I can get?
A minimum of about 15 to 18 hours.
It's way past overtime, man.
Yeah, that's way past overtime. While you're at home, she will be in the office. Whenever she's ready to be charged, she just go and find her charger, and then in the morning, when you're ready, turn her back on, and that's it.
So I can poke fun on her and say, no, I got to do overtime, right?
Well, if you want to make fun, but she won't respond.
She won't respond. She's too serious.
She's too serious.
Well, I thank you very much for, this link up. And is Innovate 10X. Yes. And where are you again?
12 Kensington Crescent.
Kensington Crescent. And where is that located?
Well, it's near Spartan Health Club or NCB Towers.
We got that. All right. And does she go to the gym ever?
No.
Well, let her do something for me. She wanted to play some music earlier. So, play some music.
Can you play some for me?
Okay.
What she actually does is just play back songs that are loaded on her.
Yes, yes, I figured that. You can use her beside your desk and just go and chill.
Yeah, just go and chill.
Interesting. Exodus. We got an exodus from here, but certainly this is also speaking to an exodus moving into this type of intelligence around the business. So quite a fitting song. And I want to thank you again, sir.
All right, thank you.
Mr. Knight, you've moved my night today. Right, I can see clearly now. All the best to you, and Michael Sharp saying pleasant viewing.